Hi, I'm Sean Gannon, and this is Minute Math, and today we're learning about how to simplify expressions with integers.
Minute Math, when you need help, you use Minute Math.
We're given these two problems here we need to simplify. Negative 2 in parentheses to the 4th power, and negative 2 to the 4th power. These have different solutions, and we're going to see why in a second. Let's start with part A. We have a negative 2 in parentheses to the 4th power. What does that mean? Well, that's a negative 2 times a negative 2 times a negative 2 times a negative 2. Okay, so the 4th power breaks it down to be the same value in the parentheses multiplied by itself 4 times. Well, negative 2 times negative 2, it's all multiplication here, left to right. Negative 2 times negative 2 is a positive 4. And bring down the rest. 4 times a negative 2, well, it's a negative 8. Negative 8 times a negative 2 is a positive 16. Remember, the whole thing, two negatives multiplied make it a positive. So negative 2 in parentheses to the 4th power comes out to be a positive 16. What about part B? We have negative 2 to the 4th power. What does this mean? Well, this actually breaks down to be this. Negative in parentheses 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Order of operations exponent comes first here. That's the way it's written, so you gotta be careful the difference here and what they look like. So the negative is actually on the outside, and we're taking the 4th power of just the 2. So the negative stays there, and 2 times 2 inside the parentheses of 4 times 2 times 2. Keep breaking it down. 4 times 2 is an 8 times 2. And then 8 times 2 in the parentheses is a 16. And a negative times a 16 is a negative 16 if it's still on the page. And there we have it. We can see that negative 2 to the 4th power without the parentheses produces a negative 16. So when you're writing this down and trying to read it, that's why these parentheses are important to designate, especially when you're dealing with exponents. I hope you learned something here on how to simplify expressions with integers. If you did, make sure you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. This helps us make more of these free math lessons for you and for everyone else. So as always, thanks for watching.